Hey there, I'm Nat.
And I'm Lo.
And we make a YouTube show about everything you never knew you wanted to know about Google or something like that.
And this is part two of a two-part episode about how YouTube works.
In part one, we go into what happens when you upload a video. If you'd like to watch that, you can check out the link in the video description.
And in part two, we learned what actually happens when you watch a video.
We didn't know the answers when we set out to make this video, so we talked with a couple of YouTube engineers, Richard and Steve and Bernard.
If you're like us when we started working on this, you might think that when you press play on a video, YouTube is just grabbing that video and playing it for you. And that's how YouTube used to work.
What used to happen 10 years ago when you watched a YouTube video, there was one file and we would just download it. And sometimes you'd watch that spinner and it was very interruptive.
So YouTube decided to do something about this, which they codenamed Sliced Bread.
Sliced Bread, as a sort of metaphor, means break the video up into pieces and so you can lay down the track for the train as it's rolling. And every time you get a piece, you decide what's the size of the next one you're going to use. And we call this adaptive bitrate.
Adaptive bitrate just means that the size of your video slices can change on the fly, which is helpful because your internet bandwidth is frequently changing.
This one.
How this works is when you press play on a video, YouTube is immediately analyzing your situation.
Is your network good? How big is your screen? How much have you downloaded already?
It might decide, hey, things are pretty good. So here's a high-resolution video slice to start things off. And here's another one and another one. But then, let's say your brother comes home and starts downloading this huge file. So your bandwidth is constrained and YouTube needs to down-res your video slices to make sure that the video you're watching doesn't have a lot of buffering.
For the most part, YouTube playbacks are smooth, but when they aren't, it's really, really irritating. And we hate that as much as anybody. And every day we're trying to make the time that the spinner shows just a little bit smaller.
Another thing that can speed up how fast videos play is where physically those video files are coming from.
It's easy to think of YouTube as a single thing, where all the videos sit in a giant pile. But in practice, when you watch a video, it gets a little bit closer to you.
More formally, this is called YouTube's Content Distribution Network. YouTube partners with the companies you get your internet from. They give them a rack of hard drives, essentially a box, for temporary storage of videos.
And when you go to request a YouTube video, instead of going to Google's central servers, you're actually going to that box.
So when you press play on a video, the first thing YouTube's going to do is check the boxes closest to you to see if they have that video.
Your browser will send a request, say, hey, give me that video.
If it's popular, it probably has it. But if the box doesn't have that video, because the video is just uploaded and has zero views, or it's never been viewed in that location, then the box says,
never heard of that video before. So it turns around and talks upstream.
And along the way, if none of the boxes have that video, the system grabs that video
from a disk somewhere in the Google data center, send it back down and say, here, you have a video, go ahead.
And what's amazing is that this all happens organically and automatically just based on who's watching what where.
I think of it like a tree. The root is in the storage, and then from there it branches out to all parts of the world.
Is that why you wore that t-shirt?
sheer coincidence.
Because people like you love to watch lots and lots of YouTube videos, including this one, thank you very much.
The ever-growing size of YouTube is hard for even the engineers to wrap their heads around.
The scale is mind-blowing. The amount of network traffic that we do, the amount of storage that we need to deal with, it boggles my mind.
Do you have a favorite part of YouTube?
I love videos. I love that people make them. I love how they're transmitted. I love it all.
Humans are weird and wonderful and creative. YouTube, being a video site, has sort of just allowed the weirdness to be documented and become popular. YouTube is a place where all of those moments can be preserved. Anybody can make them. And we will hopefully be showing those to everybody forever.
Thanks for watching.
If you
haven't, check out part one, where we talk about what happens when you upload a video. And subscribe to our channel if you like what we're doing and you want to see more videos. We also play this fun game with the engineers that we talked to called Autocomplete, and please check that out if you want to laugh.
Wait.
Bye.
Bye.